The second half just about to get underway. Here's Fisher. 8-point game. One thing you like about the Lakers, this is a team that not only Clark is a solid team at home, but they are just as terrific on the road.
Well, 23 road wins is a good mark, Kevin, but they won 29 the year before, so they did go a step back. But nonetheless, when you've got the kind of championship pedigree that this team has, you're not so much worried about what your numbers say as much as you are about how healthy you are and what level are we playing at.
And it's Richardson slamming it down.
That's how you do it. That was a nice setup. I mean, the pick was in the right place, right where it should have been.
Followed the, you know, the strategy that is mapped out on the sideline. Those timeouts mean a lot for these guys.
Yes, they do.
No good there. He's unable to convert on the three-point play.
You got to expect more out of him here. He's had a lot of difficulty this quarter, which in turn is making it difficult for them to cut into this deficit at all.
Here's Bynum. And two free throws coming up as the whistle blows. He barely missed that one. That one is off. He hits the second from the line. Here's Nash. And here's Richardson. Let's loose for three. Kept alive. Here's Lopez. Here's Warwick. And good with the shot. And the whistle blows for the contact and a chance for one more. Nice job at the line, and that one falls to pick up the and one. Here's Fisher. So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles. Tough loss coming against the Rockets in the last game they played.
There was a lot of energy being expended on the court. That's a really tough loss, a hard loss. Just not enough to come out on top after overtime.
Here is the 2K leaderboard with last season's top passing teams. But take a look at the Suns. They're fourth in the league. So good.
Well, I thought this team last season was a team that had some beautiful dimes. I mean, they would spread the floor with their ball movement and spacing and player movement. It was a beautiful thing to watch. Nice passes leading to baskets.
And here is Bynum. 9 points in the game so far. Lakers are a good defensive team last year. Clark holding and slam dunk. Wow! Now the Sprite Slam Cam for the replay.
That dunk made a statement right there.
Well, putting on a show, Clark. Such an impressive move. Here's Kobe. He's got 18. Fisher with the ball. Artest kicks to Gasol. Right side, Gasol. Fisher. behind the arc. And the Lakers with another miss.
One of the ways where they've shown a definite edge, Kevin, has come on the glass today.
Here's Nash, and almost gets it to go, so he'll shoot two here. That's on Derek Fisher. Talk about that rebounding edge, Clark. That's definitely had an impact for them in this game.
Well, I think you open up your opportunities, Kevin, when you can stay strong in the paint area and control the boards. I mean, that's a critical element in winning basketball games, rebounding the ball.
First one falls for him.
It's absolutely amazing what Steve Nash has been able to accomplish at an age when most players are mulling over their retirement speeches.
And so Nash nails both of them. Last season was probably the best of Nash's career. In fact, in some ways, Clark, better than his two MVP seasons, and he did it at the age of 36.
Kevin, in a word, unbelievable. I mean, his passing is just so special and great. You overlook what an amazing shooter he is, and he's one of the best in the league and has been throughout his career.
Here's a look at the schedule for the Los Angeles Lakers. They'll be matched up against Memphis. That'll be the latter half of this two-game homestand. No good on that one. And he sinks the second.
Going against Bynum has been a big issue for them. 10 points, and he's also been solid at the foul line. 4 points for him from there.
Courtesy of the 2K leaderboard, here's a peek at the league's top scorers from a season ago. Kobe Bryant, fourth.
Yeah, he had a terrific year last year, consistent, and ended up being one of the best scorers in the league.
Here's Nash. 2:46 left in the third. It's dumped off. Releases from 15. Jump shot is good that time. He has 7.
My goodness, Kevin, their offense has really caught fire. And if this keeps up, they won't be behind for long.
Open look, and there's Kobe. That's good on the assist by Artest. 20 points for Kobe Bryant. Suns trail by 3. Nash outside. And no good. But close on that one, so he'll shoot 2. Here's what Phoenix has lined up on their schedule. They host the Spurs after this one. They'll find themselves in the middle of this string of 3 straight at home. The first free throw is good. And so he makes both from the line. Here's Fisher. 2:05 left in the third quarter. Outside Artest. To the wing. Gasol. Pass to Kobe. Banks it home. Kobe's got 22 points.
Well, he's really been big for their team, finding a way to consistently get it done on the scoreboard.
You know, Clark, they say that Kobe observed a lot when he was in the Olympic Village when he played with Team USA.
Well, you can only imagine, Kevin. I mean, a guy like him looking at all of those other Olympic athletes, he saw the same level of dedication to their craft that he's always had. So I think that had to be affirming and inspiring for him.
The attention to detail.
Yeah.
And the Lakers call time here. Phoenix making some changes. Vito Turkoglu's checked in for Richardson. And it's Dragic in for Steve Nash. The Lakers also making some changes. Shannon Brown, he's checked in for Kobe. Here's Fisher.
Tipped. The lob was a little misjudged and he couldn't get control of it.
Dragic, covered by Artest, got the bucket and the foul.
They're amped up now, Kevin. After trailing for so long, they finally pulled ahead.
And he makes the free throw. A chance now to see Goran Dragic out of Slovenia in his third season. He was acquired by the Suns in a draft day trade with the San Antonio Spurs.
Kevin, what an acquisition that was. He was one of the most enjoyable players for me to watch all season. I mean, you look at the playoff game he had in game 3 against the Spurs, 26 points in 17 minutes. That's the most points ever in the postseason by a player playing less than 20 minutes. And I like this fearlessness. I like this composure. I like this competitive fire. Boy, he's a promising-looking player at that guard position.
They can end up with a final possession depending on how they play the clock. Here's Fisher. He's guarded by Dragic. Fades away. Blocked. Here's Bynum. Rips it down. Here's Dragic. 29 seconds left in the third. And Turkoglu backs down. Here's Warwick. And good coming off the assist from Hito Turkoglu. 11 points in the game.
Kicked it to the right guy at the right time. That's a good pass.
Now Fisher. He's guarded by Dragic. The three. Fisher can't hit. Good if it goes. No luck. And so after three quarters of play and some great offensive output, this one is tied.
Check out the game for Jason Richardson. He's got 13 points, and he's contributed 3 points from the line, too.
2K Sports, back in a moment here from the U.S. Airways Center.
It's a special Halloween broadcast of the NBA. LeBron James and the Miami Heat go on the road to battle the New Jersey Nets. The NBA season blasts off. Hoops action.
As the